We can talk about generative AI all day long, but that is what we're talking about still, the infrastructure play. This is a big event for lots of reasons. Set the scene for us. Who is coming and what do you think you'll be talking most about?
Well, first of all, thank you for having me here. It's great to be here. You know, we're excited to be here with 10,000 of our closest friends, customers, partners, press, and analysts to talk about all the great things that, you know, we're working on. You know, Ed, there's no question that we're living in one of the most interesting times in human history. You know, the rapid advancements that we see in artificial intelligence are going to really unlock the value that the world's data brings to organizations of all sizes, unlocking record levels of innovation and record levels of workforce productivity. And so you're gonna hear from a lot of great partners, stories around the acceleration of their generative AI. You're gonna hear from companies like ServiceNow, companies like Samsung. You're gonna hear about our partnerships with companies like NVIDIA, Broadcom, Intel, Microsoft. It's just gonna be a very exciting, action-packed show.
Let's talk about AI factories. So in March, Dell said, we are trying to simplify your investments into artificial intelligence. So we bring you the AI factory. What is an AI factory?
All right, so, you know, artificial intelligence is very challenging given the rapid rate of innovation that we see in this space. And so we take a very consultative approach and in terms of how we built out our factories. You know, what customers are looking for is, hey, I really need help on the use case I'm targeting. I really need help on how I do my model selection. I need help on how I do data prep on my architecture, on my infrastructure. And so we bring that strategy to bear in our AI factory, which is a combination of our infrastructure, compute, networking, and storage, all engineered and optimized under one roof. Our build out of the partner ecosystem, you're gonna hear from great companies like Hugging Face and Meta, the partnerships that we have there, and our professional and consulting services, which really help customers accelerate their deployment of artificial intelligence.
The big question that we're gonna have throughout the day is who is the buyer of AI factories, right? The story thus far has been NVIDIA selling AI accelerators or high performance GPUs to the hyperscalers and Meta, basically. Dell's history in its sales channels have been different, right? You sell to SMEs, you sell to governments. Are they the buyers of the AI factory? And in what form? I mean, what are we literally talking about here?
Yeah, and you know, like I said, this is one of the most interesting times in human history. You know, a lot of people say we're in the early innings of a baseball game, but I like to say that we're actually just pulling into the stadium and the game hasn't even started. A lot of the hype has really been around the cloud service providers and building out large training clusters. But you know, the enterprise is definitely doing a lot of POCs. What they're looking for is to deploy AI the right way. That means they want to deploy it on-prem, aligned to where their data resides, and they want to do it in an open and flexible way because they want choice in terms of how, when, and where they deploy their models.
The PowerEdge 9680 was the basically fastest selling Dell product, or first or fastest to $1 billion, which was an exciting headline, right? But what drove that? Why was it so fast selling relative to your server history, which is rich?
Yeah. So again, we leveraged, like we like to say our innovation engine is firing on all cylinders. We run the engine extremely hot. And you know, the 9680 is differentiated in the marketplace for several reasons. It's the densest 6U chassis that exists in the industry, and it's one chassis to support a bunch of silicon diversity. So GPUs from NVIDIA, from AMD, from Gaudi, all in the same design. So we have consistent rack scale design for operational simplicity. We've worked hard on our networking capabilities to offer Ethernet and InfiniBand for full maximum throughput. So it's really the best solution out there for generative AI.
Arthur, how are you using generative AI tools at home, at work? Talk to me about how you use them.
Yeah, so we're focused on four use cases right now.
I mean you as a human, as an executive, as a person.
Well, I've been using it. Obviously, Meta has, you know, some great generative AI. I've been using it with the family on Instagram, on Facebook, on WhatsApp, on Messenger. You know, the innovation in this space is happening so rapidly. It's one of the most interesting times in human history, and I'm just lucky to be part of it.
You said something interesting a moment ago, which is about the server design accommodates for different GPUs. It's GPU agnostic in many ways. And everyone keeps telling me that choice matters, you know, the ability to use different AI accelerators. but NVIDIA is still, you know, a clear leader in this market. Your job is to have really clear interaction with public and private sector customers.
Yes.
How micro-focused are they on NVIDIA versus an AMD or an Intel in the conversations that you have?
Look, customers are looking for a trusted advisor, and that's who we are. We understand this landscape better than anybody out there. We understand the compute, we understand the network, we understand the storage, we understand the ecosystem, we understand all of the services. Our job is to go in, really understand what the customer is looking to accomplish, and provide the best solution for the customer.